Okay, well, I just tried to record this, and guess what? The fucking OBS did not work, so I'm having to redo this video. Very awesome. But enough of me being fucking salty. We back. The Ganyu banner has dropped. It's been out for like a day or two. I don't know exactly. But in this video, I was gonna go over her kit and exactly, how good she is. I already did this once before, but I'm just gonna go through it really quickly. If you notice, I have Ganyun right here. I actually did two single summons on the banner and actually ended up getting her. So that's cool. I was gonna, do a couple of single summons, but not too much on the banner and save for Zhao after that, but I ended up actually hitting the pity, I believe it was, and I got her. But I'm not too terribly mad at that. I can always just go and do Zhao's banner later. Just a quick overview of what she does. Her trails of Quillen is an AoE cryo damage that bases off of HP, and it's an AoE attack. Her Celestial Shower, which is her Q skill, is an AoE cryo damage that rains down basically spikes, and it does a shit ton of damage. And it's a big AoE that is very, very good. Actually, I wanted to take a look at something. 112% duration is 15 seconds, and the CD is also 15. Okay. Basically, what her first passive does is when she uses her E skill, she gets a 20% increase in critical damage. Or not damage, but a critical rate. So that's nice. Second skill, basically, whenever she uses her Celestial Damage or Celestial Shower, she gives 20% extra cryo damage to the party. Her last passive refunds 15% of ores whenever crafting a bow. Constellations, the only ones that really matter, is the Dew Drinker. Basically, taking damage from the level 2 charge of her E skill will decrease the opponent's cryo resistance, and she'll gain 2 energy, which is very good for her to spam. Her next good one is this one, the Auspicious. Trials of the Quillen gain one more additional charge. Very nice. Western Soryorn is her next really crazy one. Basically, the opponent standing within the AoE of the Celestial Shower gets increased damage over time, up to a maximum of 15% for every 3 seconds. Very good for damaging teams. And then her last one, using her Q skill, causes the next Frostflake Arrow, which is your E skill, to not require charging, which is very cool. But yeah, that's it. Let us actually get into this again. I've actually already done this. Like I said, the fucking recording didn't. I don't know what had happened. It didn't like pick up or quit actually charging or recording. Very upset because I went in depth with that, and I don't like not going in depth, but that's okay. Just as long as you guys get the basis of what she does, and I can get the point across that she's really good. Definitely, I don't know if people sleep on her or what, but she's definitely really good. So if you pull her, congrats. She's an amazing unit. And like I said before, I realized the thing quit out. I will be doing a stream here in like probably not tonight, probably tomorrow night, of me building out my own Ganyu. I don't know exactly what to build her with though. actually, before we end this, we can quickly check and see what her artifacts are. Oh no, we can't. Never mind. Oh, it's just basic artifacts she has on this character. Okay. Oh, yeah, because I think all of them have the basic equipment on her. Okay. Yeah, that would make sense. Or, I say on her, but all the different characters they have. But, this animation is really clean as well. I really like that. But, okay. I'm not going to take up too much more of y'all's time. I just wanted to get this quick video out, just explaining my thoughts over her, and she's really good. Definitely, probably S tier, maybe. That's it. I hope you guys have a good day, and we'll have that stream here before too long. I'm out. Later.